Welcome to race number 18. We're here at Kentucky Speedway. Hillier Buck and Tony Scott starting on the front row for tonight's race. Here's the full qualifying results. There's a race command already.
Start your engines!
Engines fired up. Here we go. Getting set. Waiting for the field to roll off, and there goes the field. So once again, we're under the lights. Take a look at the back of the pack, see who's there. Kentucky's always a hard racetrack. How often have you seen someone from the back go to the front? Not very often. Who knows? So we get ourselves another winner. I believe there's only 8 more spots remaining left in the chase. ...21 being the highest running qualified driver that's already scored a victory. So let's see what happens here. Will we get a repeat or will we get a new one? Pace cars in, here we go. Getting ready for the green. Green flag is out, here we go. We're underway here at Kentucky Speedway. William Brock leading into the turn one. Sam McMillan gonna quickly take second away from Tony Scott. He'll slide right up. Get a Newman, I think she almost got turned around by Aureus all the way down to the bottom, back to the top. Two cars shooting in the middle. Here goes a 32 looking inside already. Who's gonna lead the first lap? It will be the 7. 7 at the line. He'll lead the first one. Yeah, we got a wreck. Oh, we got a big wreck into turn one. Caution's out. Caution is out. Race it back to the line. Tony Scott in the 93. Try to make it 3 wide there. 32 in the inside line. Will William Brock get a run and hang on to the lead? It's going to be close. Nope, not quite. Sam McMillan takes it. So the caution flag is out. We'll take a look at the replay. Take a look here, this happened right in the mid-pack. Jeff Bright in the 48 makes an aggressive move, takes his whole car down to the apron. And actually there was contact with the 20 and the 27. I thought Jeff Bright caused this one. Hayden got in the back of Cody. Taylor Acosta's already scored a victory, gets collected. Hard into the wall for the 78 who caused the wreck. Jasmine Acosta, another one, has already won. Matt Dalio, Wade Brummer, Jay Jefferson. 83 been a 19 car as well. Well, not that bad of a wreck. Well, for Jasmine Acosta, his car is destroyed to the garage for sure. 27. Well, that's it for her. Take a look at the replay. How hard was that wreck? Doesn't look that bad. Must hit something. Right at the onboard cam. Hit the inside wall, or no, outside wall. Oh, there's the hit from the 83. Oh, no, not the 83. There's the 83. The 47. Yeah, 47. I don't know why I said 83. Yeah, that was a hit. That's what wrecked the race car. Got it 2 more times. So, big wreck, actually, pretty much, I guess you could say. We'll take you back to the restart. Tony Green as well involved. Lights are out, getting ready for the green. About that. Sam McMillan, the 32 in front. Tonight, he is night getting that big break. So we got 39 cars remaining. Pace car is in. Here we go. Green flag is out. Here we go. We're back underway. Tony Scott now off to a good restart. Holds back a couple drivers. They look to the outside, back to the inside. See if Kayla Newman can deny someone a chase block tonight. Brad Scott in the 11 car. Actually, the 21 is the only winner so far in the top 10. Well, Scott might be able to get by the 13. Oh yeah, Tony Newman as well. Make that three cars now. There's Stuart Grayton outside of the top 10, who's already got two wins. Got them two in a row. Sonoma and Michigan. Or Michigan and Sonoma. What was it? No, Michigan and Sonoma. William Brock in the 7. Season 7 of the trucks? Or season 8 of the trucks champion. There's only been one driver who's won two championships in the top 3 series. Cup, Sportsman, and of course, trucks. And that's drivers driving a number 26 tonight. There he is, 34th, got caught up in the wreck. William Brock, not off to a good start to the season, but he started on the pole in tonight's race. He's currently second. Who else can do it? Well, Cody Smart in the 31. Remember that awesome truck finish? Can't forget it. Doesn't matter how many times I talk about it. Best championship battle. And the closest ever. Both points and the finish, the race overall. We had two other series that ended off with only a 1 point margin. First, that was in the Kroger, what was called the Kroger Short Track Truck Series, Season 2, where I think Kyle Thompson won it by a point, only winning one race over Noodles, who won three races that season, but Kyle Thomas was able to get it the last race at Hillside. 1 point, and the second time that's happened, Brandon Nicholas was the winner. He drove for the 25 team. The race ended under caution. He lost a couple spots near the end, coming to the yellow flag, but it was just enough to maintain his position. It was only a 1 point. 1 point, he got it over. And we did not use the chase, the elimination style format. So that was pretty crazy. Tony Scott at number 93, we've seen him up front a few times, several times actually, more than a few times, and we're closing in on slow traffic. AJ Green in the 77, McMillan quickly dives to the inside, puts him a lap down. This season's Daytona 500 winner, not a good night for him. Tony Scott in the 93 goes by, William Brock in the 7, Joe Jefferson in number 95 to the inside, Brian Newman and Kalen Newman both held up. Four wide almost, up to the top. Made it work. Brad Scott's Tour Green diving to the bottom. Getting right by. Keep an eye on AJ Green. Maybe a wreck. Slow cars. Usually mean wreck. I mean cautions, wreck, whatever. Well, let's just go back to the front for a bit. Yeah, Sam McMillan's still the race leader. He looks like he may have lost some momentum there. Tony Scott closing in. Five drivers in the top five. Or just say the top five. All looking for that win. Win and you're in. Scott looked outside, back to the inside. Trying to get a run out here. Top to bottom. Might work. Tony Scott now looking inside into turn two. He slips up just a little bit. He was all over him. He was there. Sam McMillan barely pulls away. Scott dives it in hard into turns three and four. Looking in the inside line. Here he goes. Battle for the race lead. William Brock, Joe Jefferson, battle for third. Side by side, Scott has the edge. Will McMillan get a run on the outside line? Let's take a look. pretty close. Really close to each other. I think Scott will get him this time. There he goes. Slides up. Crossover move. Here we go. Or just dives to the bottom. That drag race lasted way too long. William Brock, Joe Jefferson. Now they're going side by side again. Here goes McMillan on the inside line this time. Scott to the outside. Scott able to get a run off of turn two. He'll hang on to the lead. We'll get inside. Closing in on another slow car. Matt Dalio's next. Still looking. Almost gonna be single file. Tony Newman battling the two car. Currently eighth. Lost a couple spots. AJ Green being in the way. Here goes the 32 again. He's got something. Not done yet. William Brock closing in fast. Could be a three car battle for the race lead. Maybe for the race win. And the caution flag is out. Looks like the 24 is wrecked. Will they put Matt Dalio a lap down? Side by side, who's gonna get it at the yellow? Maybe the 32, he might get him here. Maybe, I think he got him. Yep, he got him. So the yellow flag is out, Sam McMillan, the 32 car. He'll take the caution flag, we'll take a look at the replay. Well, just a simple wreck here, the 24 looking outside. Looks like he was pushing Matt Scott into the 4 car. Open them into the wall, put the 24. Goes right around, and Scott able to avoid hitting the inside wall. And, whoa, actually, hang on. Right in front of the 19, and he gets into the outside wall, though. I was hoping he'll avoid it. There's a 24 going around. Currently 28th. He was 28th. We stayed green for a while. So, I don't know why they just threw out the caution. Oh, okay. We had a bunch of slow cars. And there's the yellow. You could just barely see the yellow light just flashing. So there you have it. Second yellow of the night. I'll take you back to the restart. Lights are out. Getting ready for the green. 39 cars remaining on the racetrack. Only one car is a lap down, and that's AJ Green in the 77. It was almost Matt Dalio as well, but he got saved by the caution. So 38 on the lap. 39 in total. Base car in. Getting ready for the green. Green flag's out, here we go. Nice close up here when they enter turn one. Get a nice look at the race car. William Brock, Joe Jefferson, here we go. Got a battle, Aureus might make a three wide. We got some three wide back there. 34, 20, and 5. Aureus slides up to the outside line, he goes. They're back side by side. The top two, of course, they'll pull away. Here comes Scott to the inside of one. Lots of space, really dives it in there. There's a solid white line there, that's not all that, that's part of the apron. Maybe it is, but he went all the way down there. Look how much momentum he lost. Not a good move, don't dive bomb at a track like Kentucky. But a low line isn't as great as other racetracks. Try to stay as high as possible. Scott would just pretty much draft, looks like, try to catch Sam McMillan again. This could probably gonna be down to these two drivers at the end. With Newman now in sixth, no winners so far in the top five. 88 Eli Bright, highest running, probably the highest running Henrik car we've seen. Points wise, race wise, whatever, you name it. It's tried and tried and tried. He almost got it at Daytona, he almost got it at Charlotte, he almost got the All-Star race. That, if he won that All-Star race, that would be 20 points. 20 points. Okay, there's a little contact back there with teammates, Jordan Newman and last race winner, Chris Kyle in the one car. So he's back in the hunt, defending his champion, so he's got a chance at this. Jordan Newman in the 42 is yet to win a race. The Gibbs car. Only Brad Scott has won it, and so is the 19, the 18, and the 20. Four wide. Here we go. Newman through the middle. Jamie Scrafton. Okay, back to three wide. So only two out of the four Joe Gibbs cars have already won races. Matt Haas and Cody Evans has yet to win one. Matt Haas remembering the dual race. Cody Evans, I don't know. Mixed season, I guess. There's a 96 Texas winner. I gotta take a look. I don't know if he's active or not, so we might free up a chase spot. 23 as well. These guys are rookies, so I don't really remember the user. AJ Green looks like he'll be put two laps down soon. 10 laps to go. Scott looking inside. I think these two will wreck each other. Maybe. I mean, pretty close. They're racing really hard. Someone's bound to slip up and cause a wreck. Scott looking inside. He's all over him. He's pushing him. That's not good. Push on the left side there. He's on down to the apron. He goes. This time he takes it a bit higher. Now enters the middle. Side by side for the race lead. Will William Bruck and Joe Jefferson join in? Sam clears him off the corner. Scott gonna try again on the bottom. Hoping for that lap car to hold him back. I think everyone wants that to happen. Get a better shot of winning this race. So two cautions so far. And that's about it. We only got three different leaders. William Bruck, Tony Scott, Sam McMillan. And they're all running in the top three. Here they come, closing in on AJ Green in the 77 again. Probably catch him in the middle of the corner. Scott looking inside. Will that be a good move? Because AJ will probably slide up in front. Yep. There he goes, and Scott will take the lead. William Bruck will take second. Joe Jefferson up to third. Aureus, and Sam McMillan finally gets off. He's not going to be happy. AJ Green doing some favors for his Toyota drivers. So now put Tony Scott in front. Those two fell back now. Battle for fourth. No, third. So Matt Dalio, he's entering turn one. Tony Scott has finally retaken the lead. The laps are winding down. Will we get a late caution? We'll see. Big lead for Tony Scott. William Bruck second. McMillan clears Jefferson off the corner. He's on a mission now. He's going to use everything he's got. He's probably led the most laps. I'm not going to let someone take this away from him. Probably going to catch Matt Dalio. Single file, most of them. William Bruck slowly inching his way forward. Drafting down that back stretch, looking a bit lower in that corner. Closing in. Start on the pole in today's race. Just let a few, I think. Only, I think he just let like maybe one only. Matt Dalio into three. Drivers now heading leaders into three now. Should be off of four. There he goes, off of four. So a good move for Scott, diving down to the bottom, not allowing Sam McMillan to use the bottom line. I think McMillan was hoping for AJ Green to use the bottom, but no, didn't work out. But he's closing in on William Bruck. Man, he's driving the hell out of that race car. Closing in. Maybe they won't catch him. Here we go. Let's see. Dalio still has some speed. White flag is out. One more time around. We will finish on a scheduled distance. Anything can still happen here. Anything. Tony Scott in the number 93 looking for his first win of the season and his career. Slowly pulling forward. I don't think that's going to work. Sam McMillan to looking inside. A William Brock. He won't take second. They won't catch Matt Dalio. Checkered flag is out and Matt Scott. Or no, Tony Scott. Why is he Matt Scott? We'll win it at Kentucky. So lap car pretty much ruined all that battle. Could have been a great battle for the race win. Sadly it wasn't. Two cautions, pretty clean race. That's about it. I think we should go back to the old Kentucky. I think we should. Next time around. We'll take a look at the four race results. Oh, we got a Sunoco sign, it's all black. So Tony Scott wins it, William Brock, Sam McMillan, Joe Jefferson, Aureus, Kaylin Newman, Eli Bright, Brianna Newman, Brad Scott, and Cody Smart will take it. That is your top 10. They'll get the bonus points. Here's the rest of the race results. 39 cars finished a race, 37 of them finishing on the lead lap. Tony Scott, your race winner, will now take you to victory lane.